Okay, here we are across from Reed Hall. There's a trash can and some litter. But when you come over to our side of the street, which isn't part of university property, there's a lot more litter. Let's take a look. Neighborhood volunteers cleaned a lot of this up on Friday. So that wasn't there Friday. So that has been 3 days.
It was all swept clean Friday morning.
Exactly. By a woman in her 70s who volunteered her time, carried her broom and her bag from her own house to here so that she could clean up the mess so that the children who walk back and forth to the school wouldn't have to walk through this.
Here's the one cigarette receptacle. That's the only place that people have to throw.
So some people are using it, but it's pretty gross, especially after a little light rain like we got last night. It smells like an ashtray. I couldn't even sit here and count how many cigarette butts, but I'm guessing it's going to be, you know, several hundred. And here's the trash can that I believe was installed by Mr. Biori,
yeah,
who owns this property. He expended his own money. Sometimes he pays his own staff to come and clean this mess up. Now we're crossing over to an elementary school, and it's illegal to smoke on the elementary property. The sign right there and right there. Signs asking people not to throw the trash. And yet in that first square of sidewalk, about 25 cigarette butts. Okay, this is the trash can across from the Garland parking deck and bookstore. Again, we have an area of the neighborhood that is close to dorms where people live. Obviously, they're trying to do what they can to fight this problem. This is the corner of Hall and Cleveland, where the smokers tend to congregate in the shade. Across from Leverett Elementary, school kids have been out for about 30 minutes. And so those kids who are just getting ready to walk home will walk through this. And generally, we have found that the cluster of college kids doesn't step aside or get off the sidewalk to let the children pass. Generally, the children have to kind of walk on the other side of the wall or in the street to get past this group of college kids. On Friday, I know. So what do you guys, since you live here, what do you guys think about it? I mean, does it make you mad or do you care or? You think what?
The kids know. You know what I mean?
They know.
They all know.
Yeah.
Yeah, she really appreciated your help on that, by the way.
Yeah, exactly. A broom just doesn't cut it, does it? All right, I'm going to sit here for a second.
It doesn't even look like she did anything. Yeah. Now, the main thing is that it's
it's gross.
That's just really bad.
Yeah, I think that's worse than it was yesterday. And so they're using the buckets for really more for trash.
I found them here in my person's pocket.
So this really is not the apartment complex's responsibility?
It's public sidewalk, and the apartment complex, they actually do clean it up periodically. But, you know, he pays his staff to do it, but they don't like doing it, and they've got other work to do. So I don't know how frequently they clean it up. And then some of the neighbors will volunteer.
Yeah.
Some of the guys that live in this apartment helped out. One of our neighbors was cleaning up, and he came out and helped her, so. Good morning.
Can you walk with us this morning?
Yes.
Alrighty.
See ya. About 8:15.
Hi. Hi.
Morning, gentlemen.
Morning.
Morning. Good morning. They say, you have dogs. Didn't you say this is worse today, Thursday, than it was yesterday? There is, but there's also a lot on the sidewalk, which, and there's more than there was before the bucket. Morning.
Good morning.
You all from the university?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's Friday morning, and university staff has been here to clean up cigarette butts. They were here this morning, sweeping and carrying a big garbage bag. So. It looks a lot different than it did just 30 minutes ago. And then we've got to figure out whose responsibility is it to empty these trash buckets.